We saw earlier that we could add a map fragment to our layout file and set properties on it to get some pretty interesting and cool maps. We even had a 3D flyover of New York City that was pretty cool, right? Well, that just scratches the surface of the types of app that you can build with maps integration. The XML-based maps always start in the same location, and that can be limiting for a mobile app. So in order to get a little more power and flexibility, we're going to switch gears and start using the Google Map object to complement the map fragment using Java code. Once we've gotten that, it then becomes really easy to set properties and respond to user events on the map. Let's start with an example where we set the different map types, such as the standard map, the satellite view, or the hybrid view. In this app, you can see a map of New York City, and I have control over this map by touch. I can pan around the map, and as you can see, I can pinch to zoom in and out. When I press the buttons at the top of the map, map, satellite, and hybrid, I can change the map type. So if I touch satellite, I now can see details of the buildings taken from satellite pictures. Here you can see Madison Square Garden, and even when I zoom in, I can begin to see some of the seating plans in Madison Square Garden. And of course, hybrid gives me a hybrid of the two. I can see satellite, but I can also see data such as landmarks like the Empire State Building and street names such as Fifth Avenue, as you can see here. I've done all of this using a Google Map object in my Java code. This is slightly different from the fragment that you used in the earlier sample, and we're going to dive in to take a look at how to do this next.